What's going on, everybody? How's it going? I hope you guys are doing fantastic as always. Thank you so much for joining me today on another video here on the Simply Car Things YouTube channel. Just hooning the car through some back roads today. Today is Christmas at the time that I am filming this video, so Merry Christmas to you guys. I know when you guys are going to be watching this, it will not be Christmas anymore, but nevertheless, Merry Christmas. I hope you guys are having a great holiday week, and I hope you guys are ending 2020 off on a strong note. It has been a very unconventional year, to say the least. Anyway, with all that being said, we're going to be getting into the topic of today's video, which is the AMG C63S versus the BMW M4. Which one is right for you as a potential buyer into both of these cars? They are hotly debated, they are hotly compared. Just about every single automotive journalist and publication for vehicles has compared them, put them in a head-to-head contest or competition, and they're diehard competitors. So if you guys do enjoy the content that I put out, please make sure to hit that thumbs up button. Make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel down below if you haven't done so already, and let's get into the content for today's video. So we have the BMW M4 from the F82 generation, and then the AMG C63S. Now, while these cars technically compete in the same segment against one another, they could not be more different in terms of the way that they drive, the powertrains that are offered in each of these cars, the way that they handle both on a racetrack and on the street, and the demographic of audience that is looking to buy each specific type of car. So I figured let's go ahead and break down these differences, and then we'll also talk about some of those similarities and come to a conclusion as to which car is right for you. The BMW M4 features the S55 twin turbo engine. It's an inline six, produces about 431 horsepower and 406 pound-feet of torque. All that power is sent through an electronically controlled limited slip differential, and it also features a 7-speed dual clutch automatic transmission, or you could option the car with a 6-speed manual gearbox. The car rides on optional adaptive dampers with aluminum suspension pieces, including the control arms, the suspension knuckles, the front subframe, which is also made from aluminum, and then the rear subframe is actually hard mounted to the mainframe, carbon fiber roof, carbon fiber drive shaft, carbon fiber strut tower bracing, and a lot of lightweight materials that not only increase the rigidity of the chassis of this car, but also reduce the curb weight a significant amount. There's a lot of power and a lot of racetrack engineering that goes into a car like this. With the AMG C63S, you have the M177 wet sumped bi-turbo V8 engine that is a hot V setup, meaning the turbos are sitting within the V of the engine. It produces an immense 503 horsepower and 516 pound-feet of torque, which is sent through a rear-wheel drive platform with an electronically controlled limited slip differential if you got the S variant of the C63, or a regular mechanical limited slip diff if you have the non-S variant of the C63. The AMG could only be equipped with a 7-speed MCT, which is not a true dual clutch unit, but it also doesn't have a torque converter. So it's a little bit sort of like on an in-between type basis. It also shifts very fast and it shifts very hard. You have adaptive dampers that can adjust the firmness of the shocks themselves, along with a lot of aluminum suspension components, and a lot of technology that has actually improved the handling of the AMGs quite a bit, especially when you compare them to a lot of the previous generations of C63. Now, I think when comparing the M4 and the C63S, there are certain aspects about each car that significantly cater towards a specific buyer type. Now, with the M4 is significantly lighter. The curb weight comes in right around 3,600 pounds, depending on the specification that is equipped from the factory. Whereas the AMG C63S has a curb weight of around 3,900 pounds. Depending on the specification, you could be nearly topping 4,000 pounds in that car. The significant downside of the C63S in terms of the way that it handles is the fact that it just has a significantly higher curb weight, and that obviously puts somewhat of a damper on the performance of that car on a racetrack setting or even while driving through back roads. And that's not to say that it doesn't handle well, because it does handle well. I've actually gotten the chance to drive a C63S quite thoroughly. but it just does not feel on par with the M4 in terms of the way that you can toss it. The steering on the M4 also feels sharper, it feels more direct, and you don't really get that much feedback in either car with the steering components that are used, but the way that you can sort of throw the M3 and the M4 into corners, it just has a more darty, athletic chassis that does also feel a fair amount firmer, just due to the fact that a lot of the body panels and structures on the M4 are more rigid. There is a significantly higher amount of torsional rigidity in the car as well. The C63S is a brute. It is like a German muscle car, a burnout machine. When you have over 500 horsepower and 500 pound-feet of torque being sent into those rear wheels, I mean, it's tough to put the power down, although the car does a relatively good job of doing so. It feels more punchy. It feels like it has a little bit more top end grunt when you are flat out in a car like that with the bi-turbo V8. And in addition to that, there is an amazing soundtrack that that engine produces, especially compared to the S55's inline six twin turbo unit, which sounds pretty cool in its own right, but in comparison to a twin turbo V8, well, I guess there really isn't much of a comparison. Now that we went over a brief overview of a lot of the technical attributes that the BMW M4 and C63S AMG feature, I'm gonna sit down and talk about how each of them drive real quick, and then how that can translate into you, the potential buyer that is looking to purchase one of these cars, or if you already own one, let me know if you think my thoughts are quite accurate. So, with the M3 and the M4 from the F8X generation, I think it's quite evident that the lower curb weight, the more track-focused nature of these cars, specifically from their suspension, the body panels, the lightweight construction, and just again, the overall chassis that is used in this car, is more suited towards track use and ultimately is the superior handling car. If you're someone that likes to drive frequently through back roads, if you love canyon driving, if you love going to the track, the M3 and the M4 are certainly going to be cars that are going to appeal to you, definitely more so than the AMG C63S would. If you are someone that also likes straight line speed, these cars also offer a significant amount of straight line performance, although that's not particularly what I think they excel in. I think there are better cars for that purpose, but the S55 engine is very high performance. It is, the car itself is just very driver oriented, and again, it's just going to offer a ton of rewarding performance, especially if you're that type A person. Like, on paper, you love a car that's just sort of an engineering wet dream. Well, the M4 is definitely going to be that car for you. In regards to the C63S, I think there's a lot more driver enjoyment to be had out of that car, and I think that car definitely will provoke more of an emotional response out of you as a driver. The bi-turbo V8 engine, with its immense amount of power that it produces, sending it all to the rear wheels, and also the fact that Mercedes-AMG was somehow able to engineer the sound of that power plant in such a manner that it really doesn't even sound like it's turbocharged, unless if you had downpipes where you can totally hear the turbo spool. The engine sounds absolutely menacing. It has an extremely deep growl, and it just has a very, very intense V8 soundtrack, which definitely trumps what this car has, which is that twin turbo inline six. Again, not to say that this car sounds bad, because I personally don't think it sounds bad, but the AMG exhaust note is definitely superior. There's no question about that. The other thing that I'd like to mention is just the overall grunt of having the V8, and then on top of that, the tuning potential and the power potential of that M177 power plant. You can make a ton of power reliably and consistently with those cars, and even in stock form, they pull crazy hard throughout the entire RPM band. The engine itself is extremely eager to rev, much like the S55, which is also very high revving. But the linear fashion of the way that the AMG bi-turbo V8 produces its power is definitely a nice plus. So I hope that sort of breaks down the driving aspects of these cars and what they feel like to drive. I do plan on featuring a C63S pretty soon on the channel to do a full in-depth review on it, which stay tuned for that. But the last and final thing that I would like to mention in regards to this comparison is going to have to come down to the exterior and interior design. The C63S AMG, from an exterior standpoint, has a very muscular, very beefy look to it. And it's definitely more subtle than the M cars in the sense that the body panels are just a little bit more curvaceous. They have the lines like to flow a little bit more smoothly, whereas the BMW M3 and the M4 have these very sharp, aggressive, pronounced accent lines, really wide fenders, and DRL headlights that just give them a really angry and athletic stance. And that's something that I think the M cars have been able to pride themselves with in the design department. The Mercedes, on the other hand, in my opinion, has a much more mature look in the sense that it just comes off as a little bit more luxurious, a little bit more upscale. But again, it still looks very aggressive. The front end with the gaping vents and the stance of the vehicle overall, especially if you can get one without any chrome accents and blacked out. I mean, either of these cars look really, really good. Again, the exterior looks just really are subjective at the end of the day. The interior, however, is another story. So the BMW M interiors are very driver-centric, they are very driver-focused, and I think they have great seating position with excellent ergonomics, and overall the build quality is pretty solid. With that being said though, admittedly the M interiors are a little bit on the bland side. They are a little bit more sparse, they are nowhere near as lavish or as elegant as the Mercedes-Benz interiors, and I think that is really a high point for a car like the C63S AMG, especially in the LCI facelifted models of the C63S. The interiors are absolutely stunning. The way that the design language all just sort of flows together, everything is symmetrical. There's such a nice use of high quality alloys, leathers, wood grain trim, carbon fiber, whatever it tends to be. It just looks phenomenal. And as a package overall, it is simply stunning. The facelifted models, again, have the wider infotainment screen. They have a fully digital gauge cluster, and there's a lot of racetrack app performance data that you can utilize and tap into that the car offers that the BMW M's really don't offer. So in terms of the luxuriousness, the lavishness of the interior, and the overall aesthetic design, I think Mercedes definitely wins. And I know for a lot of people, that's a really, really big selling point. So it's for sure a toss-up, and in no way is one car superior over the other. I think each car has its own set of attributes that it really excels in terms of a particular segment. But for the overall better driver's car, the overall better all-rounded performance package and machine, I would probably just give it to the M3 and the M4. Specifically, again, if you want to take it on the track, if you like to drive hard, go through canyons, the M4 is going to be the better car. If you're someone that's planning on dailying a car, you want something with a gorgeous interior that's comfortable, that has a really brash and brutal soundtrack to it, lots of power, and it's going to impress your friends, the C63S is probably going to be the better car for that. And ultimately, that is exactly what I was referring to in the beginning of this video when I was talking about how these cars are just very different in that sense, although they compete in the same segment. So I hope that was able to clarify some of your guys' questions, some of the concerns that you had. If you found this video helpful, please make sure to hit that thumbs up button. As always, subscribe to the channel down below if you haven't done so already. I do tons of car reviews, commentaries, and modifications on the build of my BMW M4. So I hope to see you guys around in the future videos. Let me know as well your thoughts in the comment section down below. I'm really curious as to what you guys think, if you agree with me, if you disagree with me, whatever the case may be, let me know in the comments and I'll be sure to engage with you all down there. As always, I'm gonna sign off for this one. I will catch you all in the next video. Take it easy, everybody. Bye-bye.